Hey everyone, this is Warbird Frank. Welcome to another episode of War Thunder. Today I am flying out the f7f Tiger Cat. Shit, I don't want to be noticed. Hey everyone, this is Warbird Frank. Anyway, we're playing a little bit of War Thunder. So yeah, we are... Yeah. Oh dear. Oh shit. Yeah, so we're finding the F7F Tiger Cat yet again. I figure, you know, like the F7F, I really, really like the F7F right now. Oh, hello, fucking Vuv. Hello, Ta. Nyers Nissi. Oh no, no, yeah. I don't know how to sing that song, but it sounds so nice. Hello. Surprise butt sex. Hey, Ta. Hey, Ta. Surprise butt sex. Jesus, that chat, though. On your money, mirsnissy. No money, no, mirsnissy. Meow, 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 meow. I'm too OP. No, come to me, Frank, poor Frank. Run away. Oh, hell no. Hew. You shall call me Papi. Hew. What's this? What? Oh. You shall call me Papi. Oh, fuck, no. Anyway, guys, I really hope you're liking this video, guys. I mean, honestly, when you guys watch my videos, it's pretty exciting to know that you guys watch my videos, you know? So, I mean, I want to do something special for you guys. So, when in this recording, I have to say, you know, thank you very much from the bottom of my heart. All right, let's see here. What are we gonna do here? All right. So the F7F is pretty cool. It's pretty good, but you have to be very careful. Okay, that's what I was talking about. All right. So what we're gonna do here is try to lure this guy down. Alright, so what we're gonna do here, what am I gonna do? Alright, he's the only one that climbed, so what we're gonna do here, we're gonna try to get some distance between us. Oh, there's a Horton. So, we're not gonna worry about the 109 too much right now. The Horton might be a problem if he decides to be a runner. So, I mean, it all depends. They could be working together. Yeah, they are working together. So, let me see here. Alright, got him. Dive away. Yep, I knew it. I knew it. Try to drag him down with me. Come on, pull up. Alright guys, we're out of the distance from that guy. There's still four people left, so I mean, I got one of them. Poor Horton 229s. I really do feel bad killing the Horton 229. I mean, they have nothing to defend themselves. They're not fast. They are maneuverable, but that only could get you so far. They don't have their real flight model yet. It was supposed to be, in reality, in a test flight with side-by-side with a 262. The Horton 229 was far superior in acceleration. Some people don't know this, but the acceleration, I mean, yes, it's a heavier aircraft, but that means it's going to dive faster, have a better acceleration time. It's only heavier by 500 pounds, but it's made out of wood. And just because it's a heavy aircraft doesn't mean it's gonna have, like, it's gonna be a slow aircraft. No, it was the complete opposite of that. The Horton 229, because it didn't have a lot of drag to it. The 262 had that issue with its engines hanging off the side of its wings. It caused a lot of drag. As for the Horton did not have that much drag issues because it was just an all-wing design. Granted, yes, the Horton 229 is gonna have rudder issues. In real life, the pilot said there's still some rudder issues I'm not used to. So yeah, it's a fact. Yes, I understand that. But you know, sometimes you need to think with your head. People don't. I'm studying aircraft to become. I'm trying to become an aircraft mechanic. Yes, I do know this. Okay. So let's just get that out of the way right now. But what do you guys think about Gaijin being like, you know, kind of our base has destroyed our victory. Okay, there's a Arado somewhere. I gotta go find that Arado. Right, where's their base at? Right, this way. Alright, a Fokko 190 F model. Right, let's go try to find this guy. But you know, throughout this whole video, you know, I appreciate it. I can't thank you enough. There's only a few of you that watch my videos. On a good day, I'll average around 120 views. That's phenomenal. 140 of you watch my videos, and I absolutely love you for it. Now, oh, there's the Arado. Okay. Alright guys, so what we're gonna do here is, I'm probably not gonna catch this guy, so Maybe I'll catch him. No, I don't think I'm gonna catch him. Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna catch this guy, but you know, I was also flying with the Great North subscriber of mine, and he's a pretty freaking radical dude. He's fucking funny. If you guys notice in chat, it was hilarious. I mean, I was reading part of it, but I really didn't know what to say to what they were doing. It was hilarious. By the way, the other subscriber is a shout out to Dauntless Tuna and his buddy Dark Skyline. You guys are awesome, okay? That's all I gotta say. Alright. Alright, let's go find this Fock Wolf, guys. I know he's somewhere around here. There's a D13 and a F variant. Oh no, it's just a D13. Well, that happened. Team killer. Well, you know, there's another thing. Team killing is not one of my it's one of my weak points. I don't like it and I don't approve of it. Team killing to me is like saying, you know, screw you, I do what I want. But at the same time, you gotta understand, you know, yes, you rage, but is it really worth it to kill someone? You know what I mean? I don't think it's like. I don't know. I really, really hate team killers. Just because they're butthurt or whatever. Whatever reason why this guy shot him, I have no idea. So. Where is this Fock Wolf, man? Sorry, guys, it's just me, you know, derping around up here trying to search for this guy. So if this seems a little boring to you, I'm sorry. So what we're gonna do to make this fun is we're going to talk about dirty jokes. Dirty joke. Yeah, boy. Alright, guys. What is your most relaxing thing? You leave a comment down below. Type in your funniest relaxation. Okay, bro. Alright, dude. Thanks for flying, dude, if you're watching this. I'll see you next time, bro. You have a good one if you're watching this. This shout out goes to you, my friend. I'm trying to cut, you know, this is what I'm talking about. The guy still team kills him or whatever, shoots him down, whatever. But, you know, he's still insisting on doing what he wants to do. See, this is an example of douchebag. I mean, look at this, man. He's still circling around Hellcat, and he got his buddy here scouting me. Look at that. I'm gonna protect this guy. I'm gonna protect this guy. This is really stupid that I have to come over here when there's one guy. Well, in all defense, that Hellcat guy shouldn't have done what he did. I mean, look at this, guys. I mean, this is something I don't approve of, but, you know, it's kind of difficult to not engage. But, you know, I'm not going to stand for this, man. mean, I do have a point. I mean, there's no need to team kill anymore. I mean, yeah, I'm sorry if this is a boring game, but, you know, trying to keep the peace. Anyway, guys, yeah, I really hope you liked this video. Sorry for the end of the conversation here at the end of the game. Kind of boring, but, you know, it had to be said. Team killing is not okay in any way. But by your teammate going back and getting revenge, it doesn't make it any better. You just make things worse. Just like you see in this example. If you're watching this video, make sure you take notes. I mean, I tried to stop it, but people don't listen. This is War Thunder. Like and subscribe to become a Warbird today, and I'll see you guys in the next episode of War Thunder. Warbird out.